This is weird. I'm not in the van world right now. I'm at home. I know it's been ages. It's been over a month. I am back. I'm going to try to be a bit more consistent. Things have gone a little bit peep-tong. A lot of stuff's been going on behind the scenes. My mental health has declined again. I know I always try to show you all the good bits. That's what my channel is about. I like to show you all the fun stuff, all the happy bits. But sometimes life isn't it's just not happy, is it? It's not fun all the time. And then when it's not fun, I then disappear from here because I have nothing to show you. So I thought this time I'm going to come on here and I'm going to tell you. I'm going to tell you that things aren't great. I'm going to come and say that, you know, I'm finding things difficult right now. But I've got so much support around me and I really want to just to assure you that I am being well supported, well loved, I'm well looked after. So everything, I'm okay. There's a lot of negativity going on in the community at the moment. Not negativity that I asked for. I'm shocked. I'm actually shocked by the way that people can behave. I don't understand it. I don't get it at all. I just want to live a peaceful, happy life. I just want to go and have fun with my friends and not be... That's my thing this year. I know my head, I just go from one thing to another. I know I can't stay on one topic, I'm sorry. This year's been all about growth for me. It's been about learning myself as a single woman. What is it that I like? What do I love? What makes me tick? You know, what is my personality like? What are my toxic traits? What can I do to make things better for me? How can I grow? And I've had to really separate myself from a lot of people to be able to do that. People that were hindering my progression. People that I learnt weren't my friends. I'm not just a channel. I'm not just this person that comes on here and shows you all my van journeys. I'm a real human being, and I think sometimes people can get those two, they get caught up in the drama, they get caught up in the politics, they get caught up in all of this, and it then becomes a war. It becomes a divide. People fall out, people start going into their own little groups. It's like a school playground. It is like in the playground, when you can't be my friend because you can't be in my group, you know, why can't we just, I do me, you do you. I don't think that that's difficult. I really don't think that that's difficult. I don't want the stress, and I'm pretty sure other people don't want the stress either. I'm trying not to, I don't want to talk about everything. I don't want to go too personal, but I also want to just explain to you guys that, you know, this is why I'm quiet. This is why I'm a bit. I'm losing my spark. I'm losing me that I've been fighting for all year, and so this for me now is me. No. I'm fighting for me again because I matter, and my feelings matter. Look at me getting all inspirational, motivational quotes. Whoop whoop. Anyway, so I didn't actually just come here just to talk shit. I actually came here to show you all the things that I've been doing quite a bit. I've been on the road more times than I've been at home, but I've not really filmed much of it. I've not done no vlogging, but I'm here, I'm back, I'm dealing with it. We're good, let's go. So the last time I put a vlog up, I was at Vanlife. So when I left there, me, Liam and Dee, we went to a little campsite south of York somewhere to go and meet with Rob Redpool and Mevy. And we had a lovely weekend. It was just relaxed, chilled out. We had bacon sandwiches, triple cooked bacon sandwiches. Pepper lived her best life, running through all the fields. She well got treated like a princess. I mean, she is, obviously. You know she's a princess, but yeah, she got spoilt rotten.
Oh, what's her name?
This is Pepper.
Oh, how old is she?
About one.
Oh, you've had her for a year? I thought you just literally just, you know...
No, she's just very tiny.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, she was prem.
Oh, After that, I travelled to a little campsite and I met up with Mevy and we reminisced over Breadgate. Do you remember that? If you don't remember that, go back a few videos because that was hilarious. One of the most funniest. And I go down a campervan camp hope video. So funny. And obviously whilst we were, you know, reminiscing over Breadgate, we decided to recreate some bread content, which I'll pop in here. And then whilst all of this was happening, Claire and David Doolittle were getting married. And so they kindly invited me to their post-wedding meetup with some friends at a little campsite in the Cotswolds. The campsite was absolutely glorious. People dressed up in Disney characters. And we did a surprise party. We all cooked some food and added to. And yeah, they wore their wedding outfits and they done their dance for us. And it was just beautiful. Yeah, so then towards the end of July, it was then the Vanlife and Overlander celebration, which is run by Carl Covey Campervan Carl. Mouthful. From Built Not Bought Campers. And he was hosting his first event at the Newbury Showground. And wow. Brilliant, absolutely brilliant event. I didn't film much, to be honest. I was far too busy having fun, but I did get some bits.
Come on, guys!
Oh, they can still skip.
Can we put your dog next to Josie's cat and see the size difference?
You can, but she might want to play with the cat and the cat might go, no, mate, I'm not doing that. Anyway, right, so when we were at Campervan Camp Out, you were struggling with weather.
You're pointing the camera at me.
Your choices of items of clothing.
He's not in the shot.
He is.
No, he's not, he wasn't, it was just me.
I can see you both.
Oh, okay. So I need a square version, there must be more. Ah, right, sorry.
No, you're just ruining it.
Yeah, so I ruined that shot. Let me get out.
Get out of my shot. Anyway.
Right.
So you got yourself a dry robe. Which, or the two bare feet, which now you're a real van lifer.
Oh, yeah.
100%. But we had a problem and we still had the shoe situation.
Yeah, and I was thinking that this time it's where I'm, the same shoes actually. Yeah. I didn't want to ruin some new ones.
This is it. So I bought you some foot condoms.
Fondoms! This is brilliant!
Especially just for you. So
hold on.
Can live your best life.
I was wondering when I was coming here, what should I do? Should I bring new shoes or just the old ones and get them wet? And I was thinking of going down the route of putting bags over my socks again.
I know.
Do these go over your shoes?
They go over your shoes. So you can now be well van lifely handsome. Living your best life.
This is brilliant.
I didn't even know these things existed.
It took a lot to find
they're
them.
They're going to drill inside them out and then they're not going to go like that, are they?
Just do it how you'd put on a condom usually.
Yeah, just don't.
Tip at the end and then roll it down.
Oh, yes!
They're so attractive.
Nike Durex. Okay. The last thing I want to do is tear them. We don't want any trainer babies.
This is actually a good example. So here you've got the front camera.
So yeah, that's been the last month or so, and I've learned a lot in the last month or so. I've learned that not everyone is your friend. I've learned that not everyone will take care of your name when you're not in the room. I have learned not to chase. I have learned to hold space for those who love me unconditionally, for those who love me for who I am and for what I bring to the table. Don't let anyone make you feel guilty for the consequences of their actions. They did this. You didn't. They did. Why are you feeling guilty? I hope I look back on this video in the future and go, Kirsty, look at you, you know, not practicing what you preach. I'm going to try. I'm working. These are all the things that I'm working on. These are things that I've learned and I'm working on. The friends that I've got, the community I've built around me this summer, I trust my name in their mouths. I trust them. I trust my name in their mouths. And unfortunately, there are some people who I've learned that you shouldn't. I'm still wearing my heart on my sleeve, and that can only be good. And I've made some beautiful friendships, forever friends. And you know, you all know who you are, and I love you all unconditionally. You are beautiful, beautiful humans.
Liamy?
Yeah?
Tell the people what they've got to do.
Have fun, party. Don't know. What they got to do?
Got to like, subscribe.
Oh, sorry. Start again. YouTube face.
Okay.
Like, subscribe, ring that bell, and share.